Advent. The season of promises. The promises of God who is faithful and committed. Jeremiah is from the tragedy of Israel's exile, 6 centuries before Christ, pointed to a future that was to come. He exults in hope. The days are coming, says the Lord, when I will fulfill the promises I made to Israel and Judah. They were vague, poetic, indeterminate promises that God will do great things for his people. And the prophet Habakkuk cries out and trusts God, even as Judah is besieged and injustice is rampant in the land. But first, in all honesty, Habakkuk reflects on the evil of his day. First, he grieves. How long, O Lord, do I cry for help? Why do you gaze on the faithless in silence? The cry of every generation. But Habakkuk concludes, even though the fig tree blossom not, nor fruit beyond the vines, though the yield of the olive fail, and terraces produce no nourishment, though the flocks disappear from the fold, and there be no herds in the stalls, yet will I rejoice in the Lord and exult in my saving God. God, my Lord, is my strength. He makes my feet swift as a deer and enables me to go upon the heights. In this time of longing for peace and justice and unity, for healing the hurts and the brokenness of life in our world and in our personal lives as well, we believers cry out, come, Lord, come and save us. And Luke in the gospel passage assures that the people will see the Son of Man coming in power and glory. Now Luke uses the rhetoric of the Old Testament, and he talks about the last day as a time of travail. The powers of heaven will be shaken, the sun, the moon, the stars, the seas, broken, hurtling in disorder. What magnificent images of the power of evil. Somehow described daily in our newspapers and on TV, and experienced sometimes in our lives as well. And then the victorious Lord will come, and he will stand before the world, and he tells the world, stand erect, do not fear, raise your heads, your redemption is at hand. So in the gospel narrative, we see two things in tension. The way in which the Old Testament describes it and Jesus uses, and the way in which he now tells his people, stand erect, do not fear, your redemption is at hand. And meanwhile, oh yes, the Lord assures us of the merciful love and the forgiveness of God. But for now, redemption is almost, but not quite. Because injustice and cruelty and violence and the suffering of the innocent need to be conquered and crushed. And that is what God promises to do in the fullness when he comes. And so we live in an interim period, but it's the time of hope. You know, hope is not a time of passive waiting, wishing, not just believing that the end will someday come. That's not hope. Hope, rather, is stretching, searching, trying to follow in the way of Jesus, so that as we believe in his coming again, we know that he's coming now. And so Paul speaks to us as we dwell to this Thessalonians. Paul says, may the Lord make you increase and abound in love for one another and for all. Not just for one another, but for all. May the Lord strengthen your hearts to be blameless in holiness before our God and Father. And how are we to do this? Why, through the instructions, Paul said, that he gave us through the Lord Jesus. Now, how are we going to do this? Unless we pray. Unless we pray using the sacred scriptures, so that we come to know what the way of the Lord is. Because unless we ponder the sacred scriptures, it'll be so vague, so indeterminate. But if we reflect on the sacred scriptures, we will be challenged to the greatest degree. Quite a prescription that Paul gives us. To follow in the minutes and hours of our day, challenging the selfishness that always lurks within us, so that we limit our concern to family and friends instead of reaching out to those most in need. Lured by the skepticism and shallowness of the culture that enfolds us, yet in our struggle to follow the Lord, even now, we give meaning to all we experience. And in our limited ways, we call down the reign of God. It's not going to happen in time, ever. But it can somehow make progress if faithful people live in the way of Jesus. Come, Lord. Come and save us, the cry of Advent. And the Lord says to you and to me, come, follow me. And with you and through you and for you, I will do it.